Yes, good morning, children. So today we are going to discuss a few questions from the Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom. Who is Nelson Mandela? The options are a freedom fighter from India, a freedom fighter from America, a freedom fighter from Africa, a freedom fighter from England. From Africa, South Africa. So he's a freedom fighter from South Africa. So what kind of freedom did he, what freedom he go for? What kind of freedom he go for? Options are freedom against Britishers, freedom from Indians, freedom from racial discrimination, or freedom from inequality? Yes, the answer is freedom from racial discrimination. Though inequality is okay, is also okay, but most important is racial discrimination. Nelson Mandela was a big admirer of, options are Jawaharlal Nehru, Margaret Thatcher, George Bush, Mahatma Gandhi. Nelson Mandela was a great admirer of Mahatma Gandhi. He followed Gandhi in getting freedom for his country. Okay, he followed all those principles which Mahatma Gandhi had followed for the freedom for his country. Okay, Nelson Mandela is a big follower of Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, then this Nelson Mandela when Nelson Mandela says that many distinguished guests have come to witness this occasion, who are these distinguished guests? Who are the distinguished guests at that ceremony? The options are the leaders from South Africa, all the prominent personalities from all over the world, all the prominent leaders from all over the world, the freedom fighters from Africa. Yes, the prominent leaders from all over the world. They were the distinguished people over there, right? So here the title says, Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. The title Long Walk to Freedom suggests, options are, the title Long Walk to Freedom indicates, options are, the struggle for freedom was very long, or let me make it better, this it took many years to attain freedom for the country. Second, it took many years for Nelson Mandela to gain freedom from racial discrimination in his own country. It took many years for Nelson Mandela to help his people gain equality in their own country. Fourth option, Nelson Mandela worked very hard for many years for freedom. So in the option, which word is very important? Racial discrimination. And second important word is, it took many long years. It took a lot of time. It took many years for Nelson Mandela to get racial, to get freedom from racial discrimination in his country. So the option which covers up these points will be the correct option. Second option was correct, I guess. Okay. Yes, Khushi, stand up. frame one MCQ from Nelson Mandela. Speak one question first. Yes.
From the given options, tell which color does not suit the African flag? Black, red, pink, or green? Right.
Okay, now the next question is coming from, raise hand those who want to speak the question. Those who are here online, they can raise hand. Yes, ready? Nana, come. All of you be ready, I'll call anyone. Okay.
When did the inauguration ceremony take place?
The question is, when did the inauguration ceremony take place? Avoid these kinds of questions. When again you require, you need to give answer of one particular year or date. So even parrots can learn it. But let's see who is not even like a parrot. Yes. So give the answer, Nana.
10th May.
It was the 10th May. Year? Year is not mentioned. Did you try to find out?
1994.
It might be 1994. Yes. Yes. Okay. Now we have the next question from Prabhun. Come on. Afterwards, Thavnesh will come. Then Chaya. Then Dishti.
Which policy created a deep and lasting wound in South America and the people of the country?
Repeat that question.
Which policy created a deep and lasting wound in the country of South Africa and its people? Okay. Options are Dr. Rhino Flaps, Subsidiary Alliance, Apartheid, and none of these.
Okay, the answer is Apartheid. You all know this answer, and none of these options will not be there in the paper. Okay, anyways. Yes, Chayank. Yes, line up here. Bhuvnesh, you also come here.
Where did the ceremony took place? Option A, at Union Building in Pretoria, in Red Fort, in Kimberley, in South Africa. The correct option is A option, in Union Buildings of Pretoria.
You are not to answer. Repeat the question. Where was this inauguration ceremony held? Answer is?
Union Buildings of Pretoria.
Union Buildings from Pretoria. Where this inauguration ceremony
was
held?
Okay.
Now Dhavnesh.
Why Nelson Mandela says that he's the sum of all African patriots?
So listen to the question again.
Why Nelson Mandela says that he is the sum of all African patriots?
First, will you correct your question? Take it mathematically.
Why Nelson Mandela?
Why does Nelson Mandela say it?
Why does Nelson Mandela say that he is the sum of all African patriots? He has spent his life with the all African patriots. He has gained experience from living with them. He has read the autobiography of the patriots.
Okay, so first of all, I would like to congratulate this boy for framing such a good MCQ. Okay, good. Even the options were very good. Okay, and another one, Even Prabhgun's MCQ was very good. Okay. So when you frame MCQ such a nicely, it means that you've got to know like what kinds of MCQs would be there in your exams. It means that you're studying like that. Okay, so frame MCQs from today onwards on your own. Okay, who, what, when kinds of MCQs would be very rarely there. And if they will be there, they will be only to help the very weak students pass. Because anyone can answer the questions to what, when, where. Okay, what 1900 something, where India, is this very difficult to learn? So conceptual questions should be there. So, okay, now listen to his question again and somebody will be asked to give the answer.
Why does Nelson Mandela say that he is the sum of all African patriots? He has spent his time with the all African patriots. He has read the autobiography of the African patriots. He has gained the experience from all the African patriots. None of the above.
Option answer would be Rahul. Let's say A option. Give the answer. That is life, but
yes. Options,
yes,
answer.
Not say yes, the answer is
experience from the African patriots.
So now the answer is
he has gained his interchange.
So that exactly because of that. But now the answer is
he has gained experience from all African patriots.
Well done. Okay, next. Now Mishti is coming. Afterwards, Kushi, you are coming.
According to Nelson Mandela, which flame can be hidden? Flame can be hidden. Man's goodness, man's hatred, woman's goodness, man's love.
Speak the answer.
Man's goodness. Option A, man's goodness.
Complete the sentence.
Option A, man's goodness is a flame that, according to Nelson Mandela, can be hidden.
Okay. Now, who will explain the meaning of this line? Man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden. What does it mean? Explain. For its explanation, I want four options. Kushi, come here. Man's goodness can be hidden. So for this, what does it mean? The options are being given by Kushi.
Options. What the question? Man's goodness is a flame that cannot be hidden.
Man's goodness is a flame that cannot be hidden. So what does it mean?
Option A, that a man's goodness does not come in front of everyone. Option B, it is not necessary that every person is good. Option C, a man's goodness is always present within him. And option D, a man shows his goodness to everyone.
Is goodness hidden?
Okay. According to me, option C was correct, where I said that a man, that goodness is present within every man, because the sentence literally means like a flame cannot be hidden no matter how hard you try. Exactly in the same way, a man's goodness cannot be hidden. It comes out in one way or another.
Yeah, it's okay. Second part of your answer is okay. Man's goodness comes out in one way or the other. It cannot be hidden. If you are good, it will be exposed. You won't have to hide it. But yes, sometimes hatred can be hidden. people are able to hide their hatred, but goodness, it doesn't remain hidden. It comes out. It gets exposed. Okay, well done, Khushi. Now your question, original question. Come forward.
Why does Nelson Mandela say that the South African defense and police would have arrested him years ago? Why does Nelson Mandela say that the African defense and police would have arrested him years ago?
I guess if people should know the answer, we are open. Now you give the options.
Option A, the South African defense and police were practiced racial discrimination. Option B, they loathed Nelson Mandela. Option C, they liked the British rule. And option D, they were loyal to the British.
Yes, have you got the point? Nelson Mandela says that he might have been arrested many years ago by African law. Because first option, she said, like those people were themselves practicing racial discrimination. Second, they hated Nelson Mandela. Third,
they liked the British rule.
They liked British rule. And fourth, they were loyal to the Britishers. So there are two options which are totally irrelevant. And out of two, only you have to find.
Option B, they were loyal to Britishers. According to the book, it was...
Okay, she says according to the book. So please bring the proof. Because whatever is written in your book, that will be correct. In the beginning, somebody came with that evidence. Who was that girl? In the beginning, who came to me? Yes. We discussed that question. Okay. So those children who are online, are they getting or not? They raise hands. Harshdeep is raising hand. Aditya. Okay. No, never mind. You just give what idea have you got. Okay. She is giving us the proof, like what makes her say this?
The book says only moments before the highest generals of the South African Defence Force and Police, their chests bedecked with ribbons and medals from days gone by, saluted me and pledged their loyalty. I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before, they would not have saluted but arrested me. This shows that they were under the rule of the British and they would have to follow whatever the British officials would have asked them to. And therefore, whether or not they practice racial discrimination, they would have to arrest Nelson Mandela.
So that is right. The same thing was in India also. When the India was under British's rule, then any Indian freedom fighter could not pursue that struggle openly. Okay, that's why many of the freedom fighters were usually arrested by the Indians itself. Okay, anyways. Okay, now who will come with question? Yes, Prabhu. Yesterday we had one question for which I asked you to bring a proof. So Prabhu will tell us what that question was. Then she will clarify the doubt also. Do you remember that question?
The question was, why was the seagull afraid to fly? And the options we all supported was that because he didn't trust it in his wings. And in to the context, it is written that he had been afraid to fly with them. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forward, to the brink of a ledge and attempted to flap his wings, he became afraid. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath, and it was such a long way down, miles down. He felt certain that his wings would never support him.
So his wings would never support him. He was sure about it. So that's why he was not ready to take a plunge, right?
According to Nelson Mandela, how can people taught to be loved? The first option, A option, is if they are taught to hate. The second option is if they are taught to be selfish. The third option is if they are taught to be taught to help others. And fourth option, if they are taught to do good deeds. The correct option is A, if they are taught to be hate, taught to hate, then they are only be able to taught to love.
Could you explain it wisely? People will learn to love only when they are taught to hate. How can you say this? Is it okay?
Yeah.
But how? Explain it from the
Okay, tomorrow I'll be asking you people to explain this fact.